morning everyone. So this is lecture 3 of chapter 2, reproduction in flowering plants. So in that we are going to understand about the double fertilization. As we have already studied in our previous lecture about pollination, its types of pollination, its agents, we already know that pollen grain is to come and it will be falling on the stigma, the receptive surface. And we also know that inside the ovary wall there will be a structure which is known as ovule, which is having our embryo sac inside it. That is our, we can say, 7 nuclei and 7 cell and 8 nuclei structure, embryo sac, is present inside the ovule. So after this we will learn about double fertilization. When the pollen tube will grow inside the style, then this pollen tube is going to reach the micropylar end, enter through the micropylar end, and it will release the two male gametes which are coming inside it. The two male gametes will be transferred and they will reach the ovule, and the filiform apparatus will help. Filiform apparatus are the finger-like structures present on the synergids. So they are the guiding, they are the guidance for the pollen tube to enter inside the ovule and to release the two gametes. So one male gamete is going to fuse with the egg and other male gamete will reach here near the pollen nuclei. So now inside the ovule there will be one male gamete, or we can say the first gamete is going to fuse with the egg cell, and the second or the other male gamete, it going to fuse with the two polar nuclei. Two polar nuclei, and this fusion is known as syngamy. This fusion is known as triple fusion, because here three nucleus are simultaneously fusing, and both of these fertilizations are known as double fertilization. So I hope it is understood very well that syngamy and triple fusion both combined are known as double fertilization, two fertilizations. This is a unique feature of angiospermic or flowering plants. Now what is the result of syngamy? The structure zygote will be there, which will be formed, and this zygote is going to develop into embryo. So later on embryo will be formed here, and triple fusion will result in the formation of primary endosperm nucleus. So primary endosperm nucleus, this primary endosperm nucleus is going to result into endosperm, a structure known as endosperm, and embryo will give rise to, we can say, either monocot seed or dicot seed. So later on this will happen in the post fertilization event. So now we will come and we will go to the next topic and see how this happens. Endosperm development. So prior to the embryo development, endosperm should develop initially. Why? Because endosperm is a structure which gives nourishment to the growing embryo. So inside the here where triple fusion has occurred, means two polar nuclei and one male gamete, they have developed in a structure called as primary endosperm nucleus. And here the zygote is formed by the fusion of egg and the sperm. So two main structures are present in the embryo sac. What happens to other structure? The antipodals, the synergids, these structures slowly are going to degenerate. Antipodals and synergids will degenerate. And next only we have functional primary endosperm nucleus. Now primary endosperm nucleus in the endosperm development, it will firstly divide many times it divides and it forms a structure called as nuclear endosperm. And this development is also known as free nuclear development, because inside the embryo sac there are many nucleus which are there present without any cell wall. So this is embryo sac, this structure, and when the PEN is dividing, it is making many nucleus, and these nucleus are just taking space inside the embryo sac. They are keep on multiplying, and the zygote is also there, which is present, which is also start dividing from one cell to the two cell. But what is main endosperm development is main, which is taking place prior to the development of embryo. Zygote will later on develop in the embryo. Now after the free nuclear development, later stages cell wall synthesis occur. And this cell wall synthesis transforms this free nuclear development into cellular endosperm. As you have seen in coconut, what you drink as coconut water. So coconut water is your nothing else but it is nuclear endosperm. And what you eat, the white portion, the kernel of white kernel of the coconut, is your cellular endosperm. In few seeds while development of embryo, complete consumption of endosperm occurs. So these kinds of seeds in which embryo development consumes complete endosperm, that type of seeds are known as non-albuminous seeds. What are the example? Example is peas, groundnut, but contradictory to this, if there is persistent endosperm if some endosperm is still remaining while the embryo development, then we call this kind of seed as albuminous seeds. Example is wheat, maize, the cereal crops which we eat mainly are the albuminous seeds. And one more thing to understand, in some cases also remains. New sellers is persistent. This is known as perisper. Example, black pepper. You can see some papery structure around the seed. That black pepper is nothing but perisper. Now we will understand the development of embryo. So development of embryo will take place. It will take place through the zygote. So now the term comes how zygote develops. So zygote develops, it starts dividing from one cell, it becomes two equal cells. And from the two cells, it will become bunch of four cells. And it starts taking a shape. To the power of two, it starts taking, it starts doing the multiplication. And it forms a structure which is called as the globular structure. At one end, it is having bunch of cells. And in the center, it is having a suspensor. And at another end, it is having a basal cell. So, basal cell and terminal cell. And it continuously changes its shape. And this is how the embryo development is taking place. This stage is known as globular stage of embryo development. In this stage, suspensor is hanging the pro-embryo, this whole structure of globular shape pro-embryo in the deep in the endosperm, and therefore globular shape will again change into the heart-shaped embryo. This heart-shaped embryo is also a development stage of the embryo, and then depending on which kind of plant it is, this is known as heart-shaped embryo. Now depending on whether it is a monocot plant or dicot plant, the shape of the embryo will going to be changed accordingly. So if it is a monocot plant, the stage of development will become different, so that the shape of the seed will become different. So monocot and dicot seeds will be developed. In monocot seeds, there will be the embryo will be single, having single cotyledon, and this single cotyledon is known as scutellum. It is present in the side, laterally present in the embryo. And cotyledon is present, which is known as scutellum, and embryo is present. The embryo will be covered by two things. It will be covered by shoot cap called as coleoptile, and the roots will be covered by root cap called as coleorhizin. Now in dicot plant, there will be two cotyledons and there will be plumule region, primary shoot, and there will be radical region on the embryonal axis. Now in the next topic, we will be studying the structure of the embryo and the fruit. What are the different types of fruit? With that, we also will understand about the apomixis and polyembryony in the next topic.